بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الريرة عند بابرخي حسن بخير رحمه الله تعالى يسير الرير ده قرآن أن أكت بان ده قرآن من الرير ده قرآن قرآن من قرآن من الكريز your grief your pain أنا قرآن عرسو من الكريز your fear of الله سبحانه وتعالى أنا قرآن عرسو من الكريز your crying to الله سبحانه وتعالى. So in effect people read the Quran and act upon, understand the Quran and they act upon the Quran, they get grief and pain, they get the fear of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and they start crying to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Once people get this thing, actually that makes their heart is pure. So it's very important that people have pain in the heart, they have fear of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and they also cry to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That really makes their life, you know, full of the purple. And that means, but that one, how it comes really when you understand the basic message of the Quran. That Imam al-Jawzi rahmullah says that the people's piety only can come when they focus on the basics of Islam. And basics of Islam is what? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, his attributes, the messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and also the day of Qiyamah. You know, remembering the day of Qiyamah that, and the day of judgment, people will be resurrected and they will be there, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will judge among them. Hisab will be there, accountability will be there, and either paradise or falafel. So these are the most important things that Quran has been teaching. That is why you can see the beginning of Islam, when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala revealed to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he did not reveal those verses which belong about Sharia, Islamic law. Only those verses kept coming to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, which are more concerned about Tawheed al-Uluhiyya, how to worship your Lord. The people must worship their Lord, no shirk. And the second verse has been about the Risala, that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam messenger, the Quran is the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and there have been many, many messengers before that. There are stories and all those keep coming. And the third emphasis has been the Quran is al-Ma'ad. Ma'ad is the day of judgment, that people will die, and after death, the time will come when they are going to be made alive. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will question them what they have done, the good deeds or bad deeds, and then they will get paradise and far off hell. So these are the main messages that kept coming in the surahs which were revealed in Makkah al-Mukarramah in the beginning of the life of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And most of the surahs which were revealed in early time of Makkah, many of them have come in the last juz of the Quran, which is starting from Ammat al-Sa'alun to Surah al-Nas. Most of these surahs, they have been revealed to Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in the beginning of Islam. Because they are short, but at the same time they are very clear, very direct. And most of them like to talk about these main messages. Tawheed, and then Ma'ad, Day of Judgment, and then Risala, and also very often Ihsan, to be nice to the people. And one of the important purpose of this whole surah is because the message can be, you know, condensed to certain words, certain sentences, so anybody can memorize them and anybody can carry them. Okay, if it's a long surah, you cannot keep the details in your mind, and very often many people cannot memorize them. Even if you memorize them, it's very difficult to focus on them. But once you have small surah and same message has been condensed very shorter, it's easy for you to memorize it, to revise it, to think about it, to reflect upon it. Like for example, Qul Huwallahu Ahad. The surah is one third of the Quran. It has got all the major attributes of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So you know, if you want to know what Allah is, what Ibadah is, read this surah. But if you understand it, the proper details. Similarly, like for example, surah Yusuf tells you that people only can be successful if they have taqwa and sabr. Surah Al-Kahf tells you people only can be successful if they have salah and sabr. Surah Al-Baqarah tells you people must have prayer and the sabr. All these three surahs, they have been summarized in Surah Al-Asr. Wal-Asr. So Surah Al-Asr teaches you to have taqwa and sabr, to have salah and sabr, and to actually have piety of sabr. Those, all these things are there. So if we actually make effort to learn this surah, you know, they will help us to also to understand the bigger surah, inshallah. And this is more surah. You know, when people remember them, or learn them, sometimes what happening is, very often when we read them in translation, we don't get the depth of the message. Very often people don't know what sabr means properly. Very often people don't know what salah means, what taqwa means. We miss this. Also the details of the qiyamah, very often don't understand. It is no doubt really very helpful for anybody to attend, you know, tafsir of class, where they can learn this properly. If there's a question, they can discuss them. So when after that, when you do the prayer, you know, these things can, you know, help you to improve your prayer and also your understanding of the Day of Judgment. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, because that is the real fiqh. Real piety, real fiqh is to understand the Day of Judgment and to understand the attributes of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and His rights upon you. You know, I want really, you know, people to reflect, to research, you know, learn properly. No doubt we make effort inshallah to finish it in the whole year. But in the beginning, there's some surah longer, like in the first surah, Ahmed al-Saloon. So I think it will be one session. you second class one session, then after that maybe you can combine two surah, and then after sometime you combine three surah, and sometime even more than that. It depends how surah there are. In the beginning, yeah, few sessions will be just one surah, and then after that maybe more than one surah, inshallah. We have started Juz Tabaraka. So 1 year we spent on that, and now after that we coming to Juz Amma. But if people have interest and and want to read, it could be inshallah, then after that we come to other Juz as well. And maybe one day the whole Quran is completed, if Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala makes us alive and gives a life and barakah, inshallah. Last to become a small surah, and also because it's the same part, because the message will be that message which was revealed to the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam in the beginning. So we need really to start with the beginning. We need the fight, we need fear of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, we need to know about the Qiyamah, about the paradise and falafel. That's why we started those surahs which focus on the ibadah, on the day of Qiyamah, on the paradise, on the fire of hell, and also on the ihsan, how to be nice to the people. Ihsan means to be nice to the people, to spend money on the people, to take care of the orphans, widows, and poor people. So because when you look after the people around you, whether Muslims or non-Muslims, that makes them to learn from you, to take from you. Because Muslims are known, they take, they never give. And the Quran teaches you to give the people. So when you give to the people, if you teach them, they learn from you. So that way from the very beginning command has been to be nice to the people, to give to them, to spend upon them, to do charity, and to look after the widows and orphans and poor people. And Ihsan means to be nice to the people. When people read any tafsir, when people write tafsir, they write tafsir, they don't write all the details. They write really certain something which can help people. But when you study with a teacher, teachers very often they will explain much deeper, they can answer the question, and also very often they can connect the Quran with people's conditions and the time where the people living, details. And also I'll make effort inshallah to teach the context of the surahs and the context of the verses of the Quran, how they connect with the verses before that, with the verses before after that. So those connections also will be mentioned. And also very often, there are certain words of the Quran, very often many tafsir, maybe they don't go deep because they expect that people must have learned. So inshallah, I'll make effort that people have full meaning of comprehensive meaning of many of those words of the Quran, which keep coming to people understand really what Quranic messages. But anyway, I don't want to praise myself. The thing is, inshallah, everybody has to know our tafsir, a good thing, inshallah, and everybody has to help, inshallah, believers to understand the Quran and to understand the message of Allah ta'ala. The main part of the Quran is three things: Tawheed, and Tawheed al-Ibadah, and the second thing is Ma'ad, Day of Judgment, and the third is Risala, the Messenger. So in the early surah, these things have been emphasized very much. But in later surahs, more details have come about rules, about laws, those things which are like branches of the main thing. When main thing is established, then after that it becomes easier to follow the law. But if people don't have fear of Allah, if they don't have the belief in the Day of Judgment, if they don't have belief in the Messenger, then basically branch nobody follows. You can see the reason because only some set of the law and people don't want to follow that. But once the fear is there, then whether alone or anywhere, they follow the law. That's why the main message of the Quran is these three things: Tawheed, Ma'ad, and Risala. Not only this, there are many other surahs, so they are part of the surahs of the Quran. It means all the surahs which teaches people about the Qiyamah, about Tawheed al-Ibadah, the Sutra Aham, so they are main usul of Islam. And most Makkan surahs, that's right, most Makkan surahs, they are really usul of Islam.